HostShop is an all-in-one automated platform to manage reseller hosting clients, commerce, billing, payments, provisioning services, communication, and support. It includes an online shop that you can integrate with your website, or you can use one of our ready-made hosting website templates to add your own branding. This guide will provide step-by-step instructions on how to set up and get started with customizing and branding your HostShop storefront. In order to brand our HostShop, we'll need to head to the Appearance area. From the side menu, select Stack CP Visual Preferences under Manage Reseller. Here, we can select a base theme to use for our HostShop instance and modify it as we like to add our branding. To install a theme, we simply need to select the theme we'd like to use and then select Save. If you would like to preview the theme first, simply select Live Preview to test the themes first before choosing the one you would like. For this example, we will be making use of the Via theme. Next, we will want to add some custom branding to this theme to make it our own. Below the theme selection area, you will see options to customize your control panel directly, such as by changing the Fatican for the site, or by altering the icons and font that the theme uses. You can then use the subsections below to change the theme directly using HTML and CSS to add and remove elements. The CSS area is where the CSS for the control panel is defined and modified. A default CSS setup is available to load, which will generate the style sheet for the currently selected theme. You can then freely modify this to update various aspects of the control panel, such as the colors of the background or the size of certain buttons. If you wish to use the base HTML that the theme uses, select Load Default HTML. You can then make any changes you like. Once these changes have been made, we can select Save Changes to update our theme. Following editing our header, we can then set up some additional customizations to further improve our branding. First, we can scroll down to find the Google Fonts area. From here, we can use a drop-down box to select what font we wish to use for our control panel. A preview text using the font is available below the field so that you can check how it looks before you save it. Once that has been set, we can also add branding and customizations to our webmail login page. This is done via HTML and CSS, much like our custom header for the control panel, and a default form can be loaded and personalized in similar fashion. The last fields are for the status page. The status page area allows for you to add and change HTML values within your white label status page, which your clients will use to check for incidents and maintenance. You can define a custom header and footer with HTML, and use CSS to style these as you would like. Now that we have some HostShop branding set up, we can begin creating our first products. HostShop allows for you to create multiple different types of product, including hosting, domains, VPS, and custom products. We'll begin our shop by setting up a hosting product. First, under HostShop, select Product Catalog. Then, navigate to the Hosting Products tab. From here, you can create your hosting products using your reseller package types. To start with, we use the Add Plan drop-down box to select the type of plan we want to create. Then we select the number of packages. This will be how many different sites your clients can host with this plan before they'll need to upgrade or purchase a new plan. Lastly, we select the allowance location, which is where we want the plan to be hosted, and then hit Add Plan. We can then set a price on the newly added plan and modify data like the description or whether the plan is paid for yearly, monthly, or at another interval. And that's it. Our first product is set up and ready to be purchased. With our first product set up, we next need to configure how our renewals work. To do this, we select Renewal Sequence on the left-hand side of the screen, towards the bottom of the Settings section. Here, we can manage how our renewals are done by the system. We can turn on the option for early invoices. This will allow for invoices to be sent with the first reminder email so that the customer can pay them early. We can also modify how often these reminder emails are sent out further down, as well as the frequency of emails sent for overdue invoices. We can then change how your renewal system handles the expiry day of a product, as well as what happens to it for different times after the due date. So if, for example, after 7 days you wish to have your products, lock the UI until payment is cleared, you can simply select the service type you wish to have this rule apply to. Then select lockout service and the type of email to send out with it. Then hit add to add this rule to your renewal sequence. And that's it. If you have any questions or need further assistance, please feel free to reach out to our support team. We are always happy to assist.